I love a good craft project. And I really enjoy making hand-bound notebooks. And I've always enjoyed doing this because I've always liked to kind of produce my crafts analog. You know, all my projects start with pen and ink somewhere in a book. And years ago, I learned how to do kind of a Japanese-style binding technique, which I remixed. And while I've been sequestered down here in Pe Ell, that's two words, Washington, I made a new batch, six of them. And they're pretty labor-intensive, but I want to kind of, you know, show you kind of what goes into them. So, let's grab this one here. My very first one started with when I made these cover art of my big drawing and art book. And I made a bunch of these on a letterpress, the former State of Washington letterpress machine. And then, let's see what I can do here. Then they got board games as the backing boards, and I found a board game called Therapy, which is pretty appropriate for me right now. And I love the way that this green hemp paper matched the green squares on the board. And sometimes they even get a little surprise on the back, so I can make a little inscription, so each one of these will get signed over to someone with by use of this fountain pen. And that's a piece of paper from Japan that I've held on to for years. And on this, you can see how the stitching work goes. And then I put another little binding on the edge to clean it up, and then there's another piece of the board game there to kind of create the hinge. So when you open it up, voila, you get a nice clean hinge there, and you can go about your work. Okay, let's take a look at a few others of these. This one here, I used a bunch of a sample pack of pure hemp paper of all kinds of different cardstocks and so on that I've had for years. And I left a little information about each of the paper sheets available, mixed in a few others, and put a little thing here, a little interdisciplinary message of Van Gogh's notebooks, and someone making a painting of Van Gogh in a new style. Everything gets a little neat, something neat. Therapy on the back, so I guess you can call this the therapy series, and a little bit of Chinese New Year's paper to kind of tidy up that edge there to go along with the binding. All right. Now this one here, it's a little bit more of a vertical layout. I'll turn it here so you can see it. And it features a silkscreen my mom made at community college in 1992 from Aspen Grove. And most of them I put my little stamps in. I have a little ink stamp that I put in. And this I left a little flap over to kind of protect it. So when you're out there doing your work, and again, this is another one part of the therapy series. But this is the blue one, because blues and grays all kind of goes together, right? Then here's another one with kind of a same kind of layout. This one's a big, thick one, laden down with paper. Therapy on the back. And then here's a set, both with some other silk screens my mom made. And this one has a whole bunch of different stuff, four or five each of the same things for my nieces and nephews to color. And my mom can play along with their own, just a bigger version, which has a special little crutch on the back because there was a bend in the board. So that's kind of how it works. I use the heck out of these notebooks myself, and well, let's face it, I just like doing an arts and crafts project. Enjoy.